The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text 14 through 19, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in July of 1966 in New York.
Name karma phale sriha iti marjo vijanati karma bhi na sa badhate. Now, you can come please forward. Yes. Come forward, guys. Karma bhi sana badhate. Now, the whole world is bound by his own karma action. Everyone, every living entity. In the Brahma Samhita, there is a nice verse about this. There is a nice verse just to beginning from the jar. There is a jar which is called Indra Gop. You know that among the living entities, the jars are in very minute form. You cannot see even with your microscope. In a space of 1 millimeter, you can find millions of germs. That is scientific truth. So beginning from the germs, which are called, please stop. Beginning from the germs up to the heavenly kingdom, the king of heaven is called Indra, and the smallest, minutest germ, it is also called Indra Gop in Sanskrit language. So in the Brahma Samhita it is said that beginning from this Indra up to that Indra, that means beginning from the germ which is known as Indra Gop up to the point of the king who is also known as Indra, all of them are bound up by the reaction of his own karma on his own work. Every work which we are doing, good or bad, we have to suffer and enjoy the reaction of our work. And so long we have to suffer or enjoy the reaction of our work, as long as we shall go on like this, so long we have to accept this material body. This material body is just given to us by the arrangement of nature's law for the exact status of suffering or enjoyment. Just like you have seen different animals, they have got different process of eating. Say for tiger, their body is made for eating raw flesh and raw blood. So all the body is so made that they have got particular nails and jaws and teeth so that they can do that. Similarly, you can see the hog, they have to eat the stool, or they have got a particular shape of mouth so that they can easily do that. Now we are human beings. We are meant for taking vegetables and fruits Now our teeth is just like knife. It can cut the vegetables and the fruits. So all this body, I mean to say, I'm giving particular space to the body. A king's body, a poor man's body, a poor man, he has to work very hard. His body is very sturdy. He can walk very nicely. But a son of very aristocratic family or king, oh, his body is very delicate. He cannot walk. He can apply his brain in something else. So long we are, these bodies are made according to the different status of our work we have done in our past life. And next body is being prepared according to the work which we are doing now. But here Krishna says that as soon as one can understand the transcendental nature of Krishna's activity, he becomes free from the reaction of activity. Now here is the question, that because we are now preparing ourselves to have our spiritual body, our spiritual life developed and being free from this material existence, therefore our duty should be such so that we may not be entangled again into this material body. That can be made possible if we are Krishna conscious, if we study Krishna, what is Krishna, what are his transcendental activities, how his energies are acting in this material world, spiritual world. All this, it is a great science. Krishna is a great science. So if we study Krishna's science with great attention, then the result will be that we shall be free from the reaction of our activity. This is clearly said here. Namam karmani limpanti name karma phalisya. The Lord has nothing to do. He is full. He has nothing to do. But why he does, just so, set example. He is not bound up by the works which he is doing in the material world. This thing has to be learned. Name karma phalasya. And anyone who understands the transcendental nature of Krishna, he is also becoming free from the reaction of karma. Evam jatta kitam karma udvairupi mumukshuvi kuru karmaiva tasmatam purvai purvakaram kitam. Now the whole spiritual process is to follow the example of the previous acharyas who have attained and success. The why were from the time they discussed. एवं दत्ता कृतं कर्म पूर्वैरवि मुमुक्षुभि कुरु कर्मैव तस्मात् तं पूर्वैः पद्म करं कृता. Now there are Arjuna, and Krishna is advising Arjuna that if you act and following the footprints of the previous acharyas and previous great devotees and kings who had done in their life karma yoga, acting for Krishna, if you follow that principle, then you shall also become free from the reaction of activity. Because Arjuna was very much afraid for being entangled in the reaction of his fighting. Krishna therefore assures that you shall not be, if you follow, if you act, or if you fight for my sake, then you will not be entangled by the reaction of karma.
Kim karma kim karmeti
किं कर्म किं अकर्मयति कवयोपि अप्रामोहिता तत्ते कर्म प्रवक्षामि जज्ञत्वा मोक्षसे असुहा. Now, people are misled. What is karma? What is actually work? And what is not work? Akarma. Kim karma, kim akarmeti. Kavayopi. Kavaya means great sages, great saintly persons, great philosophers. They are also sometimes bewildered to understand what class of activities are genuine and what class of activities are non-genuine. Therefore, Krishna says that I shall teach you what are genuine activities and what are non-genuine activities. Tatte karma pravakshani jajgata mokshasi asuha. Jajgata, if you understand the principles of working, then you shall get free from the bondage, material bond. We have to work in such a way that we may not be entangled with this material bondage. Otherwise, as we have explained, this body is our material bondage and it is the result of our activities. So we have to perform our activities so nicely and so cautiously, so that I may not be entangled, I may be free, even in this life, and taktadiham punarjanmanaiti, I can, after leaving this present body, I will have no more to come into this material world. This science is being taught by Krishna to Arjuna. And the whole activity is that if we engage ourselves, as we find it in the 11th chapter, last verse, mat karma bhik mat paramo mat bhakta sangha vajjita nidvaira sarva bhuteshu jasa mameti pandava. Now, this one verse is sufficient to teach the essence of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, that anyone who is engaged in my work, Makkarmakri. Then what is that Maiva? That Maiva is explained in the last word of the, and the last instruction of Bhagavad Gita, the Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mamekam Saranam Vraja. Arjuna is taught, and with the example of Arjuna, every one of us is taught that we have to work only which is sanctioned by Krishna. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam vraja. That is the mission of human life. But we do not know that. We do not know that. And because we do not know that, we engage ourselves with so many work which is concerned with the bodily and material conception of life. So mat karma krit. So one has to do what Krishna desires. That's why what don't they? Krishna desired that he should fight. He Arjuna did not like to fight, but because Krishna desired, he accepted to fight. This is Krishna's work. That we have to select. Now, what is the work at the present moment for us? Krishna's work. Krishna is not present now to dictate that this is my work. Just like Arjuna was fortunate enough. He was personally present before Arjuna. Lord Krishna was personally present and he was directing. But that does not mean that we have no direction. We have direction. We have direction. In the Bhagavad Gita you find that anyone who preaches the gospel of Bhagavad Gita to the people of the world, he is the most dear, the dearest person in the world, Krishna. Krishna accepts him, the dearest person. So therefore, our duty is to preach the principles of this Bhagavad Gita, to make people Krishna conscious. People are suffering for want of Krishna consciousness. Therefore, each and every one of us should be engaged in the preaching work of Krishna consciousness for the benefit of the whole world. Lord Chaitanya, whose picture you see in the front of our store, Lord Chaitanya very nicely preached this philosophy of Krishna consciousness. Amar agraya guru haiya taro sattva desh, jare dekho tare kaha Krishna upadesh. The Lord says, Amar agraya, because he came with this mission to preach Krishna consciousness. So he says, just take my order and all of you, he becomes the spiritual master, Guru Haiya. Anyone who teaches people Krishna consciousness, never mind what he is and where he should be understood the spiritual master. The Lord Krishna, Lord Chaitanya gives order to everyone that Amar Agraya Guru Haiya Taru Sadbade. Every country, province, you go everywhere and just preach this Krishna consciousness. Amar Agraya Guru Haiya Taru Sadbade, Jare Dakho Tare Kaha Krishna Upadesh. Krishna Upadesh means this Bhagavad Gita. The instruction given by Krishna, that is Krishna Upadesh. And Krishna Upadesh is also Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is full of instruction by which one can become Krishna conscious. Similarly, in the Bhagavad Gita also, we receive the instruction how we can become Krishna conscious. So Lord Chaitanya selects these very two particular books, Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita, and he asks everyone in any part of the world to take up this matter very seriously and preach in the world. That is the direct order of Krishna. So if we take up this missionary work to preach Bhagavad Gita as it is, without any interpretation, and without any motive behind it, as it is, as Krishna says, we should present as it is. People misrepresent Bhagavad Gita by their own interpretation. That should not be done. Bhagavad Gita as it is should be presented before the people of the world. They are suffering for want of Krishna consciousness. And as soon as they become Krishna conscious, their life becomes happy. So this is the mission of this society, international society for Krishna consciousness. As Krishna advises, Sangha Vardhita, you should not have any attraction or any attachment for this worldly activity. If you have got attachment or attraction for this material activity, then you cannot have Krishna, you cannot become Krishna conscious. But that does not mean you should be inimical to the people of the world. No. It is your duty to give them the highest instruction, spiritual instruction, that you become Krishna conscious. And try your best. Try your best. Nidbhaira. You should not be anyone's enemy. Others may become your enemy. Because it is quite natural. Anyone who comes with the message of the Supreme Lord, there are persons who become his enemy. Just like Lord Jesus Christ, he came. His only fault was that he was preaching the message of God, and people, some people, not all people, became his enemy, and he was crucified. Yeah. This is the world. Anyone who comes as a most, beneficial friend of the world, people take him as the enemy, and they do the same mistake again, so that they are bound up again by their own work, and they remain in this material world to repeat birth and death, one after another, one after another. So we should be very cautious. We should not miss this chance of this human body to become Krishna consciousness, to become conscious of Krishna. So, therefore, we must know how to walk. How to walk? King Karma, King Akarmeti. If we do not know how to walk, then we shall be entangled in this material activity. Therefore, Krishna says, Sangavarji. Of course, a Krishna conscious person, he also acts just like another material actor. But because he was in Krishna consciousness, therefore he is not bound up. Just like, take the example of Arjuna. He also fought just like ordinary military man. But because he fought in Krishna consciousness, therefore he was not bound up by the reaction of such fight. Fighting is not necessary. Fighting is not necessary. Peace is necessary. But sometimes peace is disturbed. At that time, fighting is also necessary. You cannot absolutely give up the process of fighting in this material world. That is not possible. Because there are persons who will create trouble, just as we are experiencing. We are not going to do any harm to anybody. But sometimes they are stunning and creating disturbing. So these disturbing elements are there, and this is always there. The material nature is like that. Therefore, fighting cannot be abolished. When it is necessary, absolutely necessary. In the battle of Kurukshetra, Lord Krishna advocated this fighting because it was absolutely necessary. So anything, it does not matter what it is. When it is sanctioned by Krishna, it has no reaction. That is the real war. Other anything which we do, which may be very good work in the estimation of this material world, but that is bound to make you entangled in this material world. This secret one should learn. Karmanurjapi bodhabvan chapi karmana akarmanasya bodhabvan ghano karmanogati. Karmanagati, the path of karma, is very intricate. Therefore, one should understand what is actually karma and what is akarma and what is vikarma. Knowing this, one should perform karma. But one thing is that if we simply engage ourselves in Krishna consciousness, then everything becomes clear. Otherwise, we have to make discrimination. What I should do, what I should not do, so that I may not be entangled. Just like in ordinary life, we may unconsciously doing something which is against the law, and therefore we become bound up by the laws of the state, and sometimes we are in trouble. Similarly, in the laws of nature also, the laws of nature is very strict. There is no excuse. The laws of nature is very stringent. Just like the fire. Fire, it burns, that is natural. This is the law of nature. So even a child, it catches fire. The fire does not excuse that because it is child, his hand may not be burned. No, that is not possible. So we have to make our work very cautiously. We have to select our work very cautiously. Otherwise, stringent laws of nature will react and we shall be bound by the laws of material nature and suffer. The Lord says, the karmano jyoti bodhabdham, one should understand how to work and one should understand what is not to be done. Akarmanasya bodhabdham. Karmano pi bodhabdham bodhamancha vikarma. Karma, akarma, vikarma. There are three things. Karma means prescribed duties. Prescribed duties. That is called karma. And akarma, vikarma, means doing against the prescribed duty. That is called vikarma. And akarma means something doing which has no reaction. That is not, of course, in the execution of such work, it appears to be working, but practically it has no reaction. That is vikarma. And that vikarma is when we ask on account of the Supreme, that is, when we Krishna Parmati, when we work under the direction of Krishna, that has no reaction. Otherwise, karma, one should do prescribed duties, and one should not do which is not prescribed. For example, just like the state has got some laws. Now, suppose if you commit murder, you will be hanged. That is the state law. So, if you against the state law, you commit some murder, you will be hanged. This is vikarma. And I should be cautious. But when the state orders itself that you go and fight, kill the enemy, that is neither karma nor vikarma. But similarly, when we act under the direction of Krishna, that is akarma. That means that karma, that kind of activity has no reaction. Otherwise, we shall have to act very cautiously so that I may not be entangled with the reaction of my karma. Karmani akarma ja paschet, akarmani cha ja karma. Sa buddhiman manusyesu sa jukta krishna karma ki. Now here is a nice verse. The Lord says, one who can see karmani akarma, any work which is being done, but it has no reaction. Karmani akarma. I am doing something, but the ultimate result of that work has no reaction. One who can see like that, karmani akarma ja paschet, akarmani cha ja karma. And akarmani means one who is trying to avoid the reaction of karma, but he is being entangled in karma. Sa buddhiman manusyesu, he is the most intelligent person. Sa jukta krishna karma kit, so he is adopted with Krishna consciousness, and therefore after doing so many works, Krishna and all sorts of works, still he is free. Karmani akarma, even working, just see, the Arjuna is fighting, and the other party, Duryodhana, is also fighting. Now, how you can understand that the Arjuna is free from reaction, but Duryodhana is not free from reaction? The fighting is both parties are fighting. Externally, ephemerally, we can see simply that they are fighting. But he is bound up by reaction, who is not bound up by reaction. Arjuna is not bound up by reaction. Why? He is fighting under the order of Krishna. So we have to see like that. Who is working with Krishna consciousness? Anyone who is working Krishna consciousness, we should see that he is not being bound up. This is called karmani akarma. Akarma means which has no reaction. So although I see somebody is working, but because he is working in Krishna consciousness, therefore it should be understood that his work is not producing any reaction. So this intelligent vision is recommended here by Krishna. That's how buddhiman, anyone who is working and who can see such work, who can understand such work, sabuddhiman manusyesu. In the human society, he is very intelligent. Otherwise, sometimes bhakti, the devotional service of the Lord, just like I'll give you a crude example, just like a boy, he is flying kite and he is moving his reel containing the thread. Now, from a distant place, you will find that he is moving his thread, but moving his reel. But sometimes, moving his reel is getting down the kite, and moving his reel is getting higher and higher the kite. So from distance less, we can see that there is moving of the reel, but the action is different. Similarly, simply by seeing the movement of a person, that he is also acting, that is not final judgment. We have to see what sort of acting is this. He is acting in Krishna consciousness. If we can see a person is acting in Krishna consciousness, then we can understand that he is free from the reaction. And if he is not acting Krishna consciousness, but externally, from our material estimation, we can see he is doing very good work. Just like Arjuna, when he first refused to work, refused to fight the mind of Krishna, it is not possible for me to fight with my relative brother. I am not going to fight. That is from material estimation, this conclusion, this decision of Arjuna is very good. Very good. So, materially, from material standpoint of view, that he is not going to commit non-violence. Violence. He is non-violent. He is very good man. But from spiritual point of view, it is not so. From spiritual point of view, it is not so. One has to see simply by external feature that one is working and one is not working. That we can. What is the standard of one? And what consciousness is worth? If he is working in material consciousness, then he is being bound up. However good may be that work, he is being bound up. Now what is the binding reaction of good material work? Just try to understand. Good material work, suppose you have done most charitable work, munificent work, and you have started so many, philanthropic institutions. That's all right. This is from material estimation. These things are very good work, but you are being bound up. You are being bound up. In which way you are being bound up? That these things are called punya karma, pious work. When you do pious work, you get four results. What are the four results? Janma, Aishwarya, Sukha, Sri. Janma, Aishwarya, Sukha, Sri. If you do pious work, you can get reaction in four ways. You can get your birth in a very nice family. Just like in the family of a Brahmin, in the family of a rich man, for pious work one can get janma. And aishadja. Aishadja means you can become very rich man by pious work. Janma aishadja sutta. Sutta means you can become very learned scholar. These are the results of pious work. Janma aishadja sutta and sri, you can become very beautiful by pious work. These are the results of pious work. Similarly, just the opposite. If you do vicious work, then you have to go to the lower class family or even the animal family. Lower class birth, become a fool, illiterate, and become not very good looking. So many things. These are the reactions of pious and vicious work. Now, taking it for granted that I am doing all pious work, that's all right. And I am getting my birth in a very rich family or very pure family, just like Brahmin family or something like that. I am getting myself very good education, I am very beautiful to see, and I am very rich man, all these. But this, our point is that suppose if you are rich man, suppose if you are very learned man, but you are not free from the stringent laws of material world. The whole point of vision should be targeted there. That I am not going to be under the stricture of this material world. If we miss that point, then we shall be captivated by this aristocratic family, or a good education, a beautiful body, or richness, we shall be. One should understand that in spite of having all these facilities of material life, I am not free from four things. Janma, mrityu, jara, vyadhi. Janma, mrityu, jara, vyadhi. I am not free from four these things, material laws of nature. What is that? I am not free from repeated births and death. I am not free from old age. I am not free from diseases. that Krishna has recommended in the Bhagavad Gita that Abrahma Bhuvana Lokan Puraravartin Arjuna. My dear Arjuna, if you go up to the highest planet, which is called Brahma Loka, where there is long duration of life and all other enjoyments, there are thousands and thousands times better than enjoyments here, but still, Abrahma Bhuvana Lokan Puraravartin Arjuna, then you have to come again. The repetition of birth and death is there also. Therefore, your aim should be Madhya Jadratyana Nivartante Tadbhava Paramamama. You have to go back to my planet, my kingdom. That will make you perfect. So, this work, good work or bad work, from the material part of you, may be superficially very good. But what? How long I shall remain a rich man? How long I shall remain a beautiful man? This is not my permanent life. Suppose if my life is for 100 years, I can remain a rich man, I can remain a learned man, I can remain a rich man, beautiful man, say for 50 or 60 or 100 years. But your life is not for 100 years or 60 years or thousands of years or millions of years. You are eternal. You have to attain your eternal life. That is the whole problem. So that problem you have to solve. That problem can be solved when you are Krishna conscious. So that by Krishna conscious, when you leave this body, you will no more have to come to this material world and accept this material body or suffer and enjoy thereof. That is the point. The point is very difficult for common man. But this is the point. This is what I have to avoid, this material existence altogether. That is the point. It is not the question of improving my material condition. That is not the solution. If I just like in a prison house, if you want to improve your condition, you become a very good prisoner and the government gives you A class status. There are three classes of status in prison life. Some are suffering the prison life in the A class status. Some of them are suffering in the B class status. There are also classes. Just like when some political leader is put into prison, they are given A class status. But a sane man should not be satisfied by becoming an A class prisoner. A class prisoner. So we are in this material world. Some of us are the A class prisoners, some of us are B class prisoners, some of us are C class prisoners. So, to become an A class prisoner from C class prisoner is not the solution of our problem. The problem should be solved that let me become completely free from the prison life. That is the whole problem. कर्मणि अकर्म जापस्येत अकर्मणि च जा कर्म सब बुद्धिमान मनुष्येषु स जित्वा कृष्ण कर्मसु. Anyone who can understand the process of karma, the process of work in this way, is the most intelligent person in this world. Most intelligent person. Not that a person who has passed any PhD examination from the university of any country. The person who understands this problem of life, he is the most intelligent person. That we should learn. He is the most intelligent person. Yasya sarve samarambha kama sankalpa vajjita jnanagni darsha karmanam tamahu pandita vibha. Pandita. Pandita means learned. And Buddha means one who is well versed. He is called Buddha. Buddha, this very term, he will find in another place of Bhagavad Gita, in the 10th chapter. Buddha bhava samanvita. Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam pravartate iti matya bhajante mam Buddha bhava samanvita. That Buddha will find in the 10th chapter. And the same Buddha, Pandita, पंडितान बुधा पंडिता अकॉर्डिंग टू भगवत गीता पंडित पंडित मीन्स लर्न एंड मैन संस्कृत वर्ड पंडित मीन्स एंड बुधा इज वेल वर्स नाउ हु इज वेल वर्स एंड हु इज पंडित ए वेरी लर्न एंड मैन फ्रॉम बाय एकेडमिक एजुकेशन मे नॉट बी a learned man according to the view of Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita says, he is the learned man who can see everyone on the equal footing, equal level. Vidya Vinaya Sampanni Brahmani Gavi Hastini Suniteta Sapakeka Pandita Samadarshi. A Pandita. Pandita can see. Pandit means a learned man can see that here is a learned Brahmin. In India, according to Vedic civilization, a learned Brahmin is considered to be the topmost man in human society. So therefore, he is taking the example that here is a very learned Brahmin, Vidya Vinaya Sampanni Brahman. Not only he is Brahmin, but he is very gentle. Vidya means, what is the result of Vidya? Education means one becomes gentleman. That is the result of Vidya. If one is not a gentleman, then his learning is not accepted according to the Vedic literature. So Pandita means that one he is learned and gentle. So another Pandit says, Vidya Vinaya Sampanni, a Brahmin, learned and gentle. Vidyavinaya Sampanni Brahmani Gobi and a cow. Vidyavinaya Sampanni Gobi and an elephant. And Sapake. Sapake ka Suniteta. Sapake means that there is a class of men who eat dog. They are counted amongst the lower class in India. Sapake ka Suniteta. Sunita means dog. So dog also not taken very good at it. In this society. But a pandita, either a dog, either a cow, either an elephant, either a dog eater, or a learned Brahmin, he sees all of them on the same level. That is pandita. Why he sees on the same level? Do you mean to say that a learned Brahmin, a high class Brahmin, he is just like as good as a dog? No. A learned Brahmin is not as good as a dog. But how then the Pandita sees on the equal footing? Because he does not see on the skin, but he sees on the spirit. Therefore is Pandita. One who has learned this art to see any living being, only the spirit, he sees. That here is a living being. He is a spiritual part, he is a spirit soul. But he has got a different body on, just like in the Bhagavad Gita. It is said that Pasam Hijinan, this body is just like our dress. Suppose a very learned man has come in a shabby dress. Do you think that he should be regarded? It is known, of course. Just like sannyasi dress, it is not very costly dress. It is a loin cloth, it is very cheap. But sometimes people misunderstand that he is a beggar, and sometimes we are respected. So, simply by dress we should not see any living entity. Whether either he is a dog or he is in the estimation of the society, a lower class man or a very high class man or a cow, but we shall see that here is a spirit soul. Anyone who can understand the spiritual vision of life, he is Pandita. He is Pandita. And according to Chanakya Pandit, Chanakya, he was a great politician, and he says, now what is the standard of education? Standard of education. Now, he has given, very nice, three words. Three words for standard of education. He is perfect in education. He says, Mātribat paradāreṣu paradarbheṣu lōsvadāt ātavat sarvabhūteṣu ja paśyati sa pandita. Pandita, this pandita. This pandita, explanation of pandita. Now, who is a Pandita? Mahasivat Paradarish. He is the learned man who sees all women as his mother. Except one's married wife, one should see every woman as his mother. Matrivat. Matri means mother. Vat means just like. Matrivat Paradarish. Paradarish means other woman, except one's own wife, married wife. Matrivat Paradarishu Paradarbeshu Lostrava. And other property should be accepted just like we few garbage in the streets. Just like we don't care for all the garbage. Simply, if others' money or others' property is there, sometimes we hanker, we should think, oh, this is nonsense. Just like garbage. Matrivat Paradarishu Paradarbeshu Lostrava Atmavat Sarvabhuteshu. And Lostra means rubbish, just like stone rubbish. There are so many rubbish and stone over the street. Nobody cares for that. Similarly, if others' money is thrown over the street, he should not care. He should not tell him, oh, there is some money, let me take. So, Mahatmat Paradayasu Paradabhesu Vastavat, Atavat Sarvabhuteshu. And he should see everyone. This Atavat Sarvabhuteshu was preached by Lord Buddha. This one philosophy was and was taught throughout the whole world by Lord Buddha. That there should be no animal king. Atavat Sarvabhuteshu. No living entity should be given suffer, even by words. That is real life. Atavat Chapashati, one who has such vision of life, he is called learned. He is called learned. Not by educational qualification. One who has acquired palena paricaya. Education is understood. How far a man is educated? By his behavior, by his vision of life, it will be estimated. Not by the degree. Atavat Sarvabhuteshu Chapashati Sapam. Similarly, Here also, the word Pandita, Pandita has been used, so I have just given you some explanation of Pandit from different angle of vision, and Buddha also. Buddha, say in Bhagavad Gita you will find the definition of Buddha. Buddha means well-versed. Well-versed means you have got studied. Lots of books of knowledge. He is called Buddha. Now everything, whatever he is doing, the ultimate proprietor is Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness. That is Gyanavali Dardha Karma. So, we can have simply, just like in an office. In an office, so many people are working. Hundreds of people are working. Everyone is conscious that whatever we are acting, whatever profit we are making, that belongs to the proprietor. Then there is peace. As soon as the cashier thinks, oh, I have got so much money, I am the proprietor. Then whole trouble begins. This consciousness, Krishna consciousness, if we understand that I am a very rich man, I have got so much bank balance, I can use it for my self-gratification. That is karma. That is karma. But if you understand that whatever I have got, it belongs to Krishna, then I am liberated first. I am liberated. This is Krishna. You will have the same money under your custody. It doesn't matter. But as soon as you think that I am the proprietor of this wealth, then you are under the influence of mine. And as soon as you think, Krishna is the proprietor of all these things, then you are free. So, kamaraga vibarjita, jnanani dantra karmana, tamahu panditan buddha. One who thinks like that, one who is situated in that consciousness, pandita buddha, he is learned and he is actually a man of knowledge. This is the whole process. Tamahu, he is known as the Pandita. Pandita means one knows things as it is, not to take a thing wrong. So that consciousness has to be involved, not only individually, but also community-wise, society-wise, nation-wise, all over the world. Then there is peace. If you want real peace, Bhokkaram Jagdhatavakam Sarvabhuka Maheshwaram Sridham Sarvabhutanam Jyattamam Santrishyati. We are just trying to be philanthropic, altruistic, and we are trying to become friends of my countrymen, of my society, of my family. But that is a wrong conception. Real friend is Krishna. I can work on his behalf. How I can work? So you try, if you actually want to do something good to your family, then you try to make all the members of your family Krishna conscious. Then your life will be successful. If you want to make them otherwise, without Krishna consciousness, then you will be serving, not serving, it will render them defect. Because any knowledge will not help your wife or children. Any knowledge, any amount of knowledge will not help. His real problem, what is his real problem, we do not know. The real problem is that we do not know. The real problem is janma mrityujara vyadhi. The Bhagavad says, pita na sasyat, janalini na sasyat. One should not try to become father. One should not try to become mother. Why? Namo-chayet-yat-samuti-tamrityam. One who is unable to save his children from the grief of material life. That should be Krishna consciousness. If you are a responsible father, then if you are completely knowledge of Krishna consciousness, then your duty will be that these creatures, these innocent creatures, now who are playing at my home, as my children, as my boy, now this life should be the last installment of his transmigration from one body to another. I shall train these boys in such a way that after this body he will have no more to go into the cycle of birth and death. That is Krishna consciousness. That means you have to make yourself expert. Then you can help your children out. Then you can help your nation out. Then you can help your society out. If you are yourself ignorant, then andha jathaam vairupaniyamana desi satantra udhani bhajya. Just like a person who is tightly bound up hands and feet. Suppose we are sitting here, some people, 25 gentlemen, ladies, and offer all our hands are tightly bound up by some rope. And if I want to make you free, although my hand is also tightly bound up, is it possible? No. At least my hand should be free. Then I can open, I can untie your bindings by the rope. So unless one is free man, and what is that freedom? One who is Krishna conscious, he is free man. And what is free man? Daivigeshagnamai mamumaya durasya mami rajaprapadanti mayamitang tarantite. Everyone is under the spell of material influence. Nobody is free. And one who has surrendered unto Krishna, one who has taken Krishna consciousness, maya has nothing to do, maya cannot touch. That's why if you come in front of the sunlight, there is no question of darkness. There is no question of darkness. If you place yourself in light, sunlight, not this artificial light. This artificial light may be extinguished at any time, but sunlight is not like that. So Krishna is just like sunlight. As soon as he comes in front of sun, Oh, there is no darkness. So there is no ignorance. So there is no Maya. Maya means illusion. So Jainavani Dagsatarma, no? Samahu, Pandita, Buddha. In this way, we have to become Buddha. Buddha means learning, learn. And we find in the 10th chapter of Bhagavad Gita that the Lord says, who is Buddha and what are the symptoms of Buddha? Buddha means learning. What are the symptoms? What are the symptoms of Mahatma, great soul? And what are the symptoms of Buddha? That is described in Bhagavad Gita. It is said that Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam pravartate iti matya bhajante maam buddha bhava sabarita. Buddha, this is the very word, again is used, buddha. So buddha, one who is learning, one who is actually in sense, is not nonsense. He is called buddha. So buddha, what are the symptoms? The symptoms of buddha is that Aham sarvasya prabhava, he knows that Krishna is the fountainhead of all emanations. Everything, whatever we find, everything, anything, whatever you see. Now take for example, the material world, the most prominent thing is, unity between man and woman. Now one can inquire, where from this attraction comes between male and female, not only the human society, but also in the animal society, the bird society, in any society, any living. This is a fact. So, somebody criticizes, but those who do not know Krishna, the Krishna had so many girlfriends, so they are something inside. But one does not know that where we get this idea of having girlfriends, unless the tendency is in Krishna. Because you can have nothing here unless that is in Krishna. But here it is Paramahata. It is pure. And Krishna, it is pure consciousness, pure spirit. That is the difference. So one who does not know, they want to avoid something. Nothing is, can exist in this material world unless it is in Krishna. Then mahadasya jataha. So these things have to be studied very scientifically and from books like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, and when he is perfectly learning, then his symptom is that he becomes a pure devotee of Krishna. Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam pravartate. I am the source, fountainhead, Krishna says. I am the source and fountainhead, of everything. One who understands this science, then he takes to Krishna. How? Buddha bhava samanvita, with full knowledge, he becomes a devotee of Krishna. Similarly, so far, Mahatma is a Sanskrit word, which is used for great soul. That is also described in the Bhagavad Gita. Mahatmanasumankartha devi prakriti nastita bhajanti ananna manaso yatta bhita adunabhaya. Mahatma. Who is the Mahatma? Who is the great soul? Great soul is he who is under the influence of the superior nature. There are two kinds of nature. Superior nature and inferior nature. Now we are under the influence of this inferior material nature. And by Krishna consciousness, we shall be transferred into the superior nature.